My lady, you could have stayed in bed for a bit longer. I was not going to wake you up from your nap, but of course, if you're ready, then we can get started. Yes, it is a glorious evening. Full moon, no clouds, and just the slightest breeze. Thank goodness. I was concerned we will have no respite after the immense chilly days this week. Did my lady perhaps wake up from the cold? No need to call Giselle then to build up the fire, my lady. Well, that's fortunate. Would not want cinders and ash to get near all this makeup. Would be a terrible thing for Giselle to witness herself, as it was her round. Lady, did you perhaps have the time to open the letter I put on the nightstand for you? Yes, from the Lady Alyssa. I was debating whether to leave it for my lady to read before you left or after you had come back, but I figured it would be best sooner. My lady prefers to read letters more early in the day, so I was glad for Lady Alyssa's letter to come in handy before getting ready for the event tonight. Pity it's not the norm for little children to attend evening charity parties, but I'm sure having received an invitation from my lady herself has more than cheered her. Have it all ready for you whenever my lady wishes. Well, by looking at your face, it seems that the light catnap has done my lady some good. I was afraid that perhaps we would have to get to our attendance for tonight. But I'm glad the long hours has not defeated my lady's youthful energy. Best to make use of it when you can. For suddenly, my lady, you may decide to jump down a few steps one day and realize that your knees have decided to skip a couple birthdays on its own. Not that I speak from personal experience yet, but I've been told to take care of certain joints here and there, especially. Youthfulness. My lady's skin seems to have a radiant glow today. A gentle sheen, I'd say, that no quality or amount of makeup can recreate. Makes my work more easier and even slightly more exciting. As if I'm a painter standing in front of a newly gifted canvas made of high quality, expensive materials. Not every day do I feel such enthusiasm to do my lady's makeup, as you may very well know. I must say, it is absolutely divine to feel such an excited but tranquil feeling as I do now, when everything seems to have been put into its place, just so I can do my already decided on the colors for today. A muted tone in both the cheeks, lips, of course the eyes. Nothing too eye-catching, but something clean and elegant, and I'm sure my lady's graceful conduct will showcase the much more than the makeup will. Using different shades of muted browns will also provide a layer of maturity onto my lady's face, as opposed to using bright colors. colours that bring out more of my lady's, I would say, childlike charm. My lady shall remind me to use the prettiest of pinks and reds on the day when Lady Alyssa comes to visit. Perhaps she would also love to be pampered herself. Having or providing a makeover always seemed to be one of the most exhilarating things I did as a young girl. And how much more thrilling would it be to receive one from whom you look up to? It would be a childhood memory a girl would never forget. Reminds me of a time when my sister and I made over our older cousin. We ransacked our wardrobes to make a queen's gown as puffy and large as our bedroom itself. Powdered on white cake flour as foundation, and even lost our mother's expensive tube of red lipstick. Disarray of fabrics, ribbons, shoes, and jewelry. My sister was determined to be the one to paint the most beautiful portrait of our first very own royal family member. And much older than us two, do not complain one bit. And did I mention, my lady, that a cousin is a boy? Or was a boy, I should say. A grown man now, married to a lovely woman with two. I remember when I first stepped into this estate. Now it seems like that was a lifetime ago. But weirdly, some memories, although much older than others, appears to me to be much more recent because of how vividly I can recall them. The strangest one. Much like a, what do you call it, a fever dream. Yes, absolutely strange. Assurance of a bold photograph or ability to share the memory with others in conversation. It's as if I can never be sure whether it truly happened or not, whether I was even in a certain place or if it was just a figment of my imagination. I wonder if my lady has many of those strange memories as I do. My lady has kept the diary since childhood, and I've never seen you miss a day's entry. Surely thinking back upon each day and writing it down helps with collection of the past. Does my lady dig through any old diaries and read them? Surely there would be things I would have completely forgotten about till I read them again. Yes, my lady is right. I would think so. Reading one's past would inspire one to do better in the present, so that mistakes been already made and documented would have a far less chance of showing up again in the future. Plus, I'm sure writing down anything every day helps one organize their thoughts, and I'm sure it has played a major part in helping articulate your thoughts, my lady. My lady is such a resplendent speaker. You are an inspiration to us all. Nearly done. Before I can confidently allow my lady to leave this room, I want to look over some spots I have missed. Wouldn't want to finish my duty any less than I'm perfectly able to do. And my lady is always patiently waiting for me, all the while trusting that I am doing a splendid job. So, I cannot disappoint my lady. Not if I can help it. Blending a little bit more. Last bit of powder. must say that making a beautiful creature more appealing to the eye is no difficult job for me, or for anyone for that matter. The foundation in all its forms is set, so what else can I add but just a slight enhancement of what's already there? Many arresting beauties have walked these halls, but the imperishable beauty of my lady's gentle and quiet spirit is even precious in God's sight. Do justice, of course, but it will have to do. If my lady